Goosebumps is rated GB7 because it may be too spooky for Goosebumps fans under 7.
Hello, Goosebumps fans. And as for the main channel, everyone, give me a second. I got to talk to the main channel real quick. So, main channel, you don't know exactly what's going on because there's just been lots and lots of rehashing and stuff. And one of the things that was accidentally said by me because, well, sometimes I have issues with me making sure I know names, you know? Yeah, it's just how it goes where it's like, I had my, I'm Slappy's Evil Twin in one hand, but way down in the couch was my bad hair day. So during the connecting phase of it, I kind of actually fudged the names. So Franz Maher, Frank the Magician. Franz Maher, Frank the Magician. One person decided to actually listen to what I said, and that was a little bit of an issue, and he thought that I said that Frank the Magician is Franz Maher. No. just no, that can't really work. You would ask, why won't it work? It makes sense. I mean, Franz Maher knows magic. Frank the Magician knows magic. Yeah, but here's the thing. It's like, number one, Candu screwed over Franz Maher. If he did that, why in the world would Franz Maher take up the mantle and be like, I'm going to be a magician too now? Does that make sense? The person that screwed him over, he's like, I'm going to be a magician too now. And then for messed up freaking thing, it's like, oh, and he just decided to screw over someone who wasn't Candu and turn the person named Amazo into a rabbit. Which he has nothing to do with anything. Franz Maher is not a jerk. His kids are a jerk. Well, in quotations, his kids are jerks. But it seems to me that he is not a jerk at all. Of course, this is until it's proven that he is a jerk. Unless it's just proven that he is a jerk. But for right now, the only accounts that we have of him being a jerk is Grave Robin, because he somehow got the Cursed Wood somehow. Since it's technically a sarcophagus, because remember it said ancient wood from Egypt, I'm pretty sure that means coffin, sarcophagus, the freaking roof of the sarcophagus is huge as hell. He had to somehow get that sarcophagus from Egypt or Africa to Britain. How did he do that? How did he do that now? But besides that, it's like, that's only one count of them. And then, of course, he made the kids. And the kids, he didn't actually made them settle down. Who knows? They just love to play jokes, you know? But it's kind of like, yeah, well, you should have a handle of your children. But on the other hand, it's like, yeah, but the children get to do whatever the hell they want, I guess, technically. So I don't know what to say on that one besides, I don't know. It's like, I have no idea. So that's the only counts of issues here, is that he created those kids. Those kids are messed up. One's going to continue on and do decades of damage. The other one, I don't know. Do we have even more of them that will do more decade of damage? But technically for Mr. Wood, that doesn't count because that was Candu. So, and besides the fact, I think only Mr. Wood had one thing that he did, I guess. It's like if we had even more books to actually have Mr. Wood before the seventh book, that will mean that he's going to have to jump backwards. And we hear more of his escapades of doing that stuff. For right now, we don't know exactly how many times anyone did anything. You don't know what Goldie's been doing. Apparently she's just been camping out in the house. What about Wally? We have no idea where he's doing or what he's doing right now, and pretty sure he's not actually active. It makes sense that he's not actually active. Alright, anyways, so it seems that Frank the Magician has been around for quite a while. And not to mention, I think Franz Maher most likely is dead. I'm pretty sure he is most likely dead. I mean, there's no way how Slappy and Snappy got out of his hands and now they're in the world. There's no freaking way. So that means that chances are when the seventh book happened, he had to have been already dead. So he most likely died in the early 90s, maybe even 80s. We don't know for sure. But considering it was 1920s, it's like 1920s. And Franz Maher is already an old man. I think Franz Maher is already an old man at this point. Maybe. But even so, it's like, yeah, we don't really know how old he is. So he most likely eventually died in the early 90s. While Frank, however, is active. He's somewhere. Yeah, he's like, he's somewhere. So I'm pretty sure is no way, shape, or form. But of course, someone would be like, oh, but it does line up. Because Frank has never returned. We haven't heard of Frank the Magician ever again. But that's also the cough up of continuity is not R.L. Stine's strong suit. Crazy thing that I didn't get talked about was like, wait, hold on. Because I'm basing this on Call on Creeps. Their podcast. Hold on. You're telling me that Amazo showed up and returned to Horrorland and no one told me that either? It's like, how dare you? It's like, they told me about the Monster Blood. They told me about that. But they didn't actually tell me about Amazo. Apparently Amazo's in Return to Horrorland. He was part of that act of that strange thingy. Huh. And besides, the big spiel is this. The real reason why I'm saying that Franz Maher is not the same as Frank, but of course it's like, then that means that he had to have been a rabbit for like decades too before Franz Maher died. So we don't really have like a big pinpoint of when Slappy and Snappy came. I still have to believe the idea that Amazo could have actually went to Franz Maher. Franz Maher taught him the way to bring the dummies alive for exchange. He made him a freaking dummy suit. So it's an exchange. I like that idea. And, well, because someone's been harping about what Snappy's really made of, we know exactly what he's made of. Hardwood. The finest hardwood. There we go, it fits. We now know what his dummy suit is made of, because remember, many people have already said that when it comes to Slappy, Snappy, and everyone else, they look too human. Way too human to tell if they're a dummy unless they look very up close. How in the world did he have a dummy suit? Amazo has a dummy suit, and yet no one called him out on it and say that he's just a winning dummy. This is weird. What's going on here? What the hell? It's like, I'm pretty sure that Amazo had to have had one that looks very, very lifelike. And the only person we know right now that's able to do that is, of course, Franz Maher. And the messed up part is like, if he was Frank the Magician, why in the world would we help Amazo? Besides the whole dominance. At any moment, I could take this dummy suit away for you, destroy it, and look at you, you're a rabbit again. Oh, that sucks. And it's like, okay. But Franz Maher seems to be like a good guy, though. I'm pretty sure he wouldn't have done that in the first place. Why would, you know, Amazo get crossed by him? I mean, yeah, we could go to the idea of like, he could, I'm a double agent. I'm going to try to at least make a little bit of a branch to say that what if he was. Then that means that technically he saw Amazo as a human. Mm-hmm. He actually talked to Amazo. Amazo taught him a spell. And sadly, well, Franz Maher not being good with magic said a messed up spell and he turned him into a fucking rabbit. And now they have no idea how to reverse it, even though it's like, yeah, but then the carrots, though. Explain the fucking carrots. Oops. It's like, yeah, that's the only freaking loophole in this. It's like, but the carrots do revert back after some hours. His is permanent. Supposedly permanent. And it's not even a part of where I thought that in the book, not only is permanent, but he can transfer it. Means that Tim is now a bunny, but Amazo is human again. Yay! But for Calling All Creeps, they basically said that no, he's still, Amazo's still a rabbit. Tim became a rabbit, but I thought it was transferred. I thought the thing was transferred. Anyways, it'll be corrected later down below or something. But yeah, for me personally, I have to agree that the fact of Franz Maher and Frankie the Magician are not the same person. That was an accident that I said that because I was looking at one book and forgot the other book's name. He's like, yeah, it's like, it happens so many times, you know, just like the whole thing of where it's like, who's that guy with the red green shirt and the messed up face and the hat? Oh, Michael Myers. What the fuck? Everyone's like, what the fuck? No, that's not Michael. That's Freddy Krueger, man. Well, they both have messed up faces. His jumpsuit can be blue and red and green because of the acid that thrown at him at one point. Anyways, I'm just saying that was a little bit of a oops. So for anyone who actually got confused, along with the person that was confused, no, I am not saying that Frank the Magician and Franz Maher is the same person. But I will say that Franz Maher most likely was the solution to help Amazo continue his act for exchange for learning magic. And plus it kind of conflicts and contradicts. It was like, okay, well, you're saying that Franz Maher learned magic from Amazo. How in the world does the freaking magic to turn Amazo into a rabbit if he needs to learn how to do the magic in the first place? Yeah, but it's like, yeah, but you just said, though, he actually learned it in human form, and he screwed up one spell, and now Amazo's a rabbit. Yeah, but wouldn't you think that Amazo would figure out how to actually make himself not a rabbit again, and Franz Maher wouldn't be like, oop, I'm sorry, but I'll make a suit for you until I figure out how to do this. It's like, you're learning magic. Amazo knows magic. That means that Amazo should already know the spell and be able to tell you what to say to reverse it, right? And yet he doesn't. It's like, yeah, that's kind of like, what the hell is this, man? But anyways, there you go. Hopefully you understand now what I'm saying. This is my line. This is where I'm putting my line here. Unless we can find some extra proof to make it like Franz Maher is a jerk and he is Frank the Magician, which I doubt we can. They're not the same person. And Franz is a good person, even though he created messed up monsters. I was Gary Knight.